In today's video, I am going to explain basic anatomy, function, and important myofascial connection of butt muscles, glutes muscle. There are three glutes muscle. In this picture, I'm going to explain the biggest muscle. That's this one. This is gluteus maximus. Freaking big muscle. It basically originates from pelvis and sacrum. But if you look origin of gluteus maximus very deeply, you will find new idea. Let's see. That attaches to ilium, basically ilium, okay? Posterior part of ilium. Then it attaches to sacrum. Sacrum, and it attaches to fascia, attaches to myofascia. But here, this fascia is called thoracolumbar fascia. This fascia is on back part of body. So if gluteus maximus gets tight, maybe thoracolumbar fascia gets tight. Then it can create tension around this fascia. What's gonna happen? Then that can be cause for low back pain. See, that's important. Ilium, sacrum, thoracolumbar fascia, and a little bit more. Deep to gluteus maximus, there's connective tissue attaching to sacrum and ischial tuberosity. This ligament is sacrotuberous ligament. Sacrotuberous ligament, huh? That sounds very important. And some anatomy books say gluteus maximus attaches to fascia of gluteus medius. So, fascia of gluteus medius. I'm going to talk about gluteus medius later. Anyhow, gluteus maximus attaches to fascia of gluteus medius. That means gluteus maximus and gluteus medius have some kind of relationship, don't you think? Fascia of gluteus medius. This is origin. This is just origin. How about insertion? Insertion is femur. I'm not gonna explain that every single detail. It attaches to femur. Easy, right? Then one more place, that's connective tissue, that is iliotibial bone. This connective tissue is also important. This connective tissue goes to all the way down to knee joint. Thus, if gluteus maximus gets tight, that may create cause for knee pain because of myofascial connection. See, as gluteus maximus is big muscle, there's so many attachments and attaches to related fascia. Let's look at its function. Main function of gluteus maximus is hip extension. Strong hip extensor plus external rotation. External rotation. Then you can divide gluteus maximus for two parts. Lower fiber and upper fiber. Lower fiber actually can do hip adduction. Hip adduction. Upper fiber can do hip abduction. Okay, abduction and adduction are different. Abduction is leg up. Then adduction is leg down. Gluteus maximus can do completely opposite movement. Depends on the fiber. Anyhow, extension, external rotation, abduction and adduction. This is about gluteus maximus. It originates from various parts of pelvis and sacrum, plus lower back. Then it attaches to fascia and bone. Then it can do so many movements. Let's go to gluteus medius. This is gluteus medius. This is profile view. Buddhist media originates from about here. Anatomy books explain about gluteal line. Gluteal line. But I personally remember it's below iliac crest. It's just below iliac crest. Okay, this is my way to remember. Insertion is here. This is greater trochanter. Simple, right? Gluteus maximus was huge muscle. Thus, there's so many attachments. But gluteus medius is simple. Gluteal line and greater trochanter. Oh, by the way, don't forget. Gluteus maximus attaches to part of fascia of gluteus medius. That's important. Let's go to function of gluteus medius. Main function is hip abduction. Hip abduction. This is important for hip abduction. And you can divide gluteus medius for two parts or three parts. Let's say I divide it two parts. Anterior fiber, posterior fiber. Anterior fiber can do a little bit more function, not only the hip abduction. It can do flexion, hip flexion, and internal rotation. And because gluteus medius attaches to pelvis, that can move pelvis this way. What kind of movement is that? That's anterior tilt. Anterior tilt. Then, this posterior fiber is completely opposite. Remember, anterior fiber does flexion, internal rotation, and anterior tilt. It's gonna be completely opposite. So, posterior fiber can do extension, external rotation, and posterior tilt of pelvis. Posterior tilt. Oh, by the way, gluteus maximus also can do posterior tilt because it also attaches to posterior part of pelvis. That makes sense. General function of gluteus medius is hip abduction. Depends on whether anterior fiber or posterior fiber. It can do many other movements. Gluteus medius, so important. Deep to gluteus medius, there is the smallest gluteal muscle. That is gluteus minimus. Okay, this one is gluteus minimus. I kind of highlighted gluteus minimus because it's deep muscle. Imagine there is gluteus medius, superficial from minimus. It's from pelvis. It's from below gluteal line. Insertion is greater trochanter. Greater trochanter. Well, function is quite similar like gluteus medius. Main function, abduction. Hip abduction. And same like gluteus medius. You can divide to two parts. Yep, it's gonna be same. Anterior fiber does flexion, internal rotation, and anterior tilt. Flexion, internal rotation, anterior tilt. How about posterior fiber? It's completely opposite. Extension, external rotation, and posterior tilt of pelvis. And gluteus medius and gluteus minimus are important for hip pelvis stabilization because small muscles are important for stabilization. Gluteus maximus is not that important for stabilization. Rather, maximus is big joint mover. It's big bone mover. Compared to gluteus maximus, gluteus minimus and medius are kind of intermediate-sized muscles. Thus, they have important role for stabilization, same as joint movement. Okay? So personally, I take care of these three muscles as equally, because gluteus maximus, big joint mover. Minimus and medius are more like joint stabilization. So I should not prioritize these muscles. They are all equally important. In today's video, I explain basic anatomy and function of gluteal muscles. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.